definitely an honor, definitely a pleasure being here. All my family, my children. I'm very, very happy to be here today. Lynette is definitely someone very, very special. She has made my life very special. Excuse me, just give me a moment. Okay, all right, the talk now. All right, so let's backtrack a little bit. His name is Harry Maharaj. One reason Carrie Savannah Road went to Montrose School together with Lynette, so we go way back. Migrated to the US when we were about 16, 17, 18. We were very special friends. Which, you know, back in those days, if you get a little old, and we go to Jubilee, and he went to buy seats in balcony, use the man. I was the man then. I just save all my lunch money to buy seats in Jubilee. Okay, I came to Lynette's home, I met her parents, but 17 years old, all I wanted to do was just have fun. I never took her serious. She knew what she wanted in life. She told me how she felt about me. She used to write me letters. But the thing about her letters, she didn't tell me in person. It only was hopping on a plane to go back to New York. I used to read all these letters. All right, no problem. So, you know, life is a journey. We both had different paths in life. After I got divorced, I was looking for this girl. I started asking my aunts, my uncles, do you know what Lynette Sandal is? So my aunt told me, she's not married, but I don't know what her last name is. Couldn't find her. I spoke to a couple of my cousins. They don't know that she got married. They don't know where she moved to. I went on social media. I found one person, her name was Lisa Sandal. So I put a friend's request in. So finally started chatting with her. After one day I said, do you have a sister by the name of Lynette? Or I couldn't remember her sister's name. Or do you have a cousin by the name of Lynette? They said no. I said, okay, so I deleted her from Facebook. Okay. So 25 years has passed. I was in Trinidad for just before the Christmas, going to Miami. My Uncle Parry, who's not here tonight, was dropping me at the airport. A lot of traffic going to the airport. I thought I was late. I ran into the airport, ran into the counter. They said, calm down, the flight is late. So you're okay, no problem. So here I am, sitting on the plane. The plane is practically empty. I see these two nice young girls walking in. It was Lynette, which I didn't know it was Lynette, and a friend of hers, a co-worker. So here I am, a single guy. Two nice girls walking the plane. They said hello, I said hi. So when I said hi, she said hello, I said hi. She said, I saw you run into the airport, where are you coming from? I said, Chagones. I said, Chagones. She said, we're in Chagones. So I said, Karen Savannah Road. She said, we're in Karen Savannah Road. I said, this damn girl knows him, man. I said, two houses from Triple K Bakery. She said, is your Aunt Shamo and your Uncle Glenn? I said, are you Lynette? And she said, are you Sona? And big hug. So, like I said, the plane was empty. I was hungry. They had all the snacks in the world. I sat with her and a friend, ate their snacks. I mean, I went in the seat in the back and we spoke the whole flight from New York, from Trinidad to Miami. Okay, we spoke, and at that point, you know, life is a funny thing. Life is a journey. We had different paths in life. We went separate ways, and somehow or the other, I believe in destiny, we reconnected. At that moment, we both were single. We kept in touch. And maybe 8 months later, after we met on that flight going to Miami, we met with each other for the first time again. And I gave her an envelope.
So she said, what's this?
She thought I was probably given a backup airfare to come into New York. But I ain't that stupid. I was thinking for her. When she opened the envelope, it was pictures of Lynette when she was 16, 17, in her little pom-pom shorts. Top cut all the way over here. She was shocked. She couldn't believe it was her. She said, where did you get these pictures from? I said, I never threw those pictures away. I saved it. I had a lot of the girls' pictures growing up. I dumped everything, but as I kept. And I'm saying this in the presence of my children. They just want me to be happy. That's the main thing. So, without any further delay, I have to call upon my family up front who wants to wish Lynette a happy birthday. Mom and Shamo, all you guys come. They want to wish, they came from New York, they came from Canada. They want to wish Lynette a very happy birthday.
You know what? The person who I have to thank the most for this was my mom, who is not here to us today, but I'm sure he's listening above and he's given us all his blessings. He is the one that introduced me to Lynette. He's the one that set this up. But destiny has a way of coming back. And I believe in destiny. I believe she is my destiny. And I believe that we were meant to be. And I'm going to try to make her the happiest person for the rest of her life. Thank you very much.